I'm nothing like Leonardo da Vinci. I don't have moments of genius. The producer has sent me this book. I'm supposed to fill it in with my own moments of genius. I don't have moments of geniuses. How did da Vinci do it? 20 ideas, I need 20. I haven't even got one.
Hello?
Mr. Producer, I'm so glad you called. Yes, I was just writing down some ideas. But my pen ran out. Yes, my pen ran out. I couldn't write them all down. I only got some of them down. You want one of the ideas done as a painting? You want to hear what it is now? I had this idea of a troll. Riding a horse. You like that idea? Oh, damn. I suppose I should paint it then, shouldn't I, Mr. Producer? Hello? Hello? Oh, good, he's gone. Now we can tell him how much we hate him. Mr. Producer, may I say I hate all these tasks. I would rather sit around eating lots of chocolates. Oh, you're still there. Getting right onto the painting, and may I say, I enjoy our conversations. It really motivates me into painting masterpieces. Over to the other angle.
So here we have something a little bit different. Here we have a our troll type character. Is it a troll? Is it an ogre? I'm riding a horse. Now, is this a regular size horse or is this a really small horse? Is the ogre really small? Or is the ogre man size? All things to question. But while we think about all that, we just need to see if we can get this down on some card using the watercolours and gouache mix. Mixed media. Yeah, so I designed this on Photoshop and I've coloured it and everything to give us something to do. So I'm thinking, should I draw it first or should I just get painting? And I'm umming and ahhing about that. As you do. So I might just put this somewhere so I can see it. That's what I'm gonna do. So I've just put it on like my drawing pad and I put something on it just to make the drawing pad angled so I can look at what I'm doing. Right, I might just paint, you know. Well, let's just do an example of the basic drawing of what we've got. So we've got the horse head out there. So you can really do that with two circles. And then you just connect them. Something like that. Yeah, it's about right. And the neck. And then the horse body, I see it as just a block. Part of the body there, and then the bottom part of the body about there. Shape sort of like that. Something like that, and that's about there. Something like that. I think that's about right. Something like that. Yeah, it's something there anyway. Hey, maybe we could put a funny ear on this. character and turn it into a another Yoda type character. That's not a bad idea, is it? So this is the head, body. It's only got a small body and a leg. And the foot goes sort of there. Something like that. And the tail. Just lightly rub it out. Can still see some of the marks. Just gives me a good chance to get going on what I like the most, painting. So I'm gonna get some burnt sienna. Start quite thin, and we'll start washing in the basic shapes, like the head. Now the reason I don't usually use pencil is it can muddy your colours because the graphite can lift up and I don't really like that. So I tend to, generally, don't tend to draw that much, to be honest. I tend to just paint. But it's good to, when you're doing something a bit more complicated, a bit harder, sometimes it is a better idea to get your sketch in first, give you a better chance. better chance of not messing it up. Just using burnt, you know, some more. You can use that same burnt sienna for the part of the ogre. Okay, and there we've got one of the legs, the other one about there, I think. So I remember when I was first trying to do horses, really struggled. They always looked like dinosaurs. Well, there's still a chance of this happening again. But if it does, we'll just go with it. I don't mind dinosaurs. One thing I do like is copying the Disney ones, Disney horses, because they've simplified all the shapes and you can get an idea of things. We use photos you've taken of horses. And also plenty of pictures on the old internet of horses. Oh, I think we've got something there. So maybe we can get a bit of this green and a bit of the burnt umber. Just blobbing a bit of that in the head. This and that. That nose is in line with the top of the head. So just do that there. Just getting the basics. Positions, a bit of red. Bit of this dirty red for the hair. So the hair of the blowing. Something like that. Okay, so I think I'll let this dry. I think I could do with this drying, and then I can start putting in the darker area of the background. Unless I start over here and let it dry as I go. Bit of the brown, black, ivory black. Bit of that Prussian blue will be good as well. And start blocking in some dark areas. The old dark, more dark. So I'm not using a wash brush. I kind of want there to be different sort of layers. What I mean is, I'm not using a big brush and just washing it on, because I want there to be like texture. I'm switching between blues and browns and blacks, just to keep things keep a variety in there. So it's not just sort of a dull ivory black, it's got more to it, really. Just getting all that dark area in. Because what we can do afterwards is start bolstering things a little bit. Some bit of red in there. So I'm just grabbing some vermilion red and a bit of ultramarine blue there. Getting a little bit of some difference down here. Dark. Okay, so what I think I'll do is leave that to dry and see what we get. I keep saying that, but then I think, I can carry on a bit. Hopefully you can see this okay. I know it's so reflective, but when it dries, you'll be able to see a bit better. It's just a lot of darks, a lot of dark areas. And I think what I'll do while I'm having fun, get some of this blue and red, push some of this in here. Yeah, this is actually looking all right. It's starting to come together quite nicely. The good thing about using gouache, I found anyway, is you can get things going quite quickly with my oils. I find I have to wait a bit more. If I'm doing something more complex, I have to wait for things to settle and have to scrub the paint on. I do enjoy it though. I enjoy that as well. Yeah, me, I just enjoy my painting. Whatever painting it is, I'm enjoying myself. Alright, let's let that dry. Okay, so it's all nice and dry now. So we can start detailing the horse, I think, and that's what I'll do next. And also get this area in. So I might do using this round brush. It's only a cheapy brush. Got some of this umber. We can put in the clothing. I just went for sort of a normal, I say normal, I just went for sort of this brown clove when I was designing it. You don't have to do the same as me, you can change yours to be the way you want it to look. So I want kind of an orangey colour. Just move that over here. Put that brown as well. Touch more red in it, that's better. Some more of the red. Stop building these colours up a bit. At the moment, it just looks a bit boring, doesn't it? As we start to develop things, that wants to be more. Burnt sienna, the orange. The foot there. The arm there. Get a bit of this browny colour, the burnt umber, and with the burnt sienna, I think. Yeah, something like that. Start building this up as well. This back leg can stay quite dark. I'm going to have all the water kind of splashing up there as well. Got the belly of the horse there. Really filling in. I always forget that I'm filming when I'm painting because I get so involved. Just getting some of this yellow and the red. Just little places. Thinking about the part of the head. I think I might block in the hair and the face a bit more. So I'm thinking some of the burnt umber. It's green. I think it's just a viridian green, probably. Can't remember. But just use any green. The thing is, with the palette of colours that I'm using, don't feel you have to use the same. Just use what you've got. You don't have to use the same colours. All you need is a green, a blue, a yellow, a white, an orange, a red. And you can mix your colours to whatever you want. What I'll do is I'll try and a good idea for me is to do a painting with totally different palettes of colours just to prove the point. Do the same painting. Something like that. This has been designed quite simple because I'm painting it and I like need it to be easy. When you're doing yours, you can change things. Do it the way you want it to be. That's not too bad. So what I might do now is work on the hair. So this is ultramarine blue gouache there, and I've got a bit of this magenta. Just so you know. Yeah, quite like that. might try. I don't mind getting that area done. So a little bit of ivory black and a little bit of the burnt umber. Don't know if you know, but ivory black and burnt umber mixed makes Van Dyke brown. Yeah, Van Dyke brown. Because that's how they make that. When they pre-make it in tubes, that's what they use. I might change, I might have it going. Using this dark again, can darken up this bit here. This rear, this leg here. Quite like the way that I put some light on that one, so do that again. Bit of darkness in here. It's starting to develop a bit more. More dark along here. Here. This is it. This bit of that, bit of developing him in there, get a bit of that dark in there. Just get rid of these light areas, we don't want any light. Go into a bit of the black and I can get rid of some of this. Let that dry. Okay, so that's dried. Now we can start putting in a bit of detail. So I've got a bit of burnt sienna and white gouache, that is. Burnt sienna acrylic and then white gouache. Making a light colour to get some of the head area, like the brow. I don't mind this being quite a dry paint because then you get these breaks in the paint, which is good. I like that. The light there. Need to get this body correct, so sort of in line with the nose, about there. See how the paint's breaking. So that's because there's not that much water on the brush, which works for us quite nicely. Oops. Might use a bit of it to just get a bit more of the burnt sienna. Always sort of sitting back having a look. I've got some of that red as well, look. Some of that red here. Vermilion. Get some of that in places. If you ever find there's a bit too much, you can use your finger to just get rid of it. So I'm going to get some of this red burnt umber, a nice dark red, and put some of that under here. About that leg there. Move that burn umber. Warmth under there. Okay, quite like that. starting to come on a bit. Getting rid of these grey bits we don't want. And we can use brush strokes as well. Little bits of like red there. This area. Darkness under that. I don't think you can see that hoof because of the splash of the water there. I think because there's quite a lot of a watery splash along the bottom. But we'll worry about that later, not so much now. So what I might do is get some of this white and blue. A little bit of the purple as well. To lighten that tail. Okay, quite like that. And then these hairs here, I'm just going to give them a little glint. It's almost like they've got that sort of purpley blue end to them. There's some areas that have not quite gone dark enough, like here. Clean that up a bit. While we're using the blacky brownie colour, we can start looking at the nose there. The mouth. And then the eye. I like that design better, actually. That's more straighter. And then the curves are on this side. Darken in certain areas. Okay. use the finger to shape it, mold it, improve things. Need a bit of a whitey colour. Some of this white, some of a greyish colour. It works quite well with the brown and black on the brush, I think. Might use a bit of the purple. Sort of a purpley brown. Funny how characters start developing in a painting. And I quite like that more than the original, because I felt like the original didn't quite have a character in the face. Let's just get these ears. Yeah, I do like that. Just need to darken under there. Need to start painting these hands in and things. What I might do is start doing the character of the rider, maybe the eye over there. Sometimes I wonder if it's easier to do the light first of the eye or the black first of the eye. I'm always wondering stuff like that. So I'm taking my time on this painting on purpose, because I want it to look good. And not only that, I'm enjoying it. Some of this yellow here. Now this yellow will do better. The cadmium yellow, that. I'm going to start lightening up areas. Try and bring out the face a bit on this character. Okay. So put the nose. There's the head sort of goes like that. shirt. Chin. Yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna have the forehead like that, nose, and the chin. The eye there. Just give my horse an eyelash there. Smile. Quite clear up the character, have we? That's a bit better. And the toes. Darken that. A bit more dark in that part. Light for the eye. A bit of purple for a smile. I'll just dry it first. Just do the smile to there. I'm using that same pinky colour. I might building up the hair. Some light on here. The hair. A little bit of a darker green, because I want to pull out some detail. Just getting some yellow, bit of white. We can get some green in there as well. We can pick up some further little light bits. Not too much of the water. So we've got some light going there. Okay. I think what I'll do, using some ready blue, I'm gonna get some quite dull purple for the hair. Thank you. And with some really light. just catch some of this hair. Some light. Not all of it. We can leave some of this. Quite like that. A little bit of this pink in with this as well. Might give her a little bracelet there as well. Earring. An earring there. Okay, we want to get it to be splashy now. So what I want to do is cover it. Use this canvas panel. My favourite thing to do. Get some white and some blue. Bit of that blue as well. Some white and blue. And we can do some splashes. Like I said, my favourite thing. So I'm gonna be going that way. Oops. Oh, I'm making a right mess now. Just tap that away. Must hold too much water, that brush. I won't use that. Oh well, we live and learn. Let's try this brush instead. Yeah, it's better. It was just too big. Got water splashing up. Some areas, what I'll do is I'll get more white. Straighten it up a bit. Let's have a look at that. I quite like that. And some splashes there. It's quite good.
use the brush to get the movement in the water. A bit of brown just to bring that back there. Okay, now I want to add a little bit more light. The yellow. Yellow and white. And then just a bit of light going on the top here. Oops. Yeah, quite like that. So we can take it further, we can always two more. Maybe I can more yellow on top of the hair there. Light there. Okay, so I think I'm about there. Yeah, what it's like, you can keep going and going and you think, oh, I could just do this, I just do that, I could just add that there. But you've got to think, eventually, it's probably about right. About time to finish, I think. We'll call this one done, shall we? I just wanted to do one. where the other eye goes. Putting more splashes up there. So what I need to do now is just darken things over this side a little bit more than what it is. Just to help the characters stand out a bit. Just using the black and brown mix. Okay. And then, just to create another layer, get some of this yellow and white. I'll draw in a few little bits, plants. Okay, just dry that.
I'm still writing down more moments of genius. Lots of ideas and... anyway, if you'd like to see another episode, there's one there and there's one there. I'm just going to write down more fantastic ideas.